in the world did you do to me?
Sir?
I don't know who this man is!
Drop your weapon. This is your first warning.
Those ships... nothing but lies!
Drop your weapon. This is your second and final warning.
Why? Why? Why, you son of a bitch! Why?
Externally indistinguishable from humans? When in God's name did robotics get this advanced?
The tech to build a robot skinned in a living layer of cells has been around for some time now. It's just been illegal.
Oh, it's much more than that, gentlemen. The AI is particularly fascinating. Far beyond our products here at Bergen. We can barely even analyze its neural structure.
Well now, Mr. Bergen, this is ridiculous. You are supposed to have the most advanced R&D in the world. And now you're telling us that someone is just a teensy bit ahead of you?
Only because we haven't been allowed to venture into that potentially lucrative area, General. Perhaps if this government hadn't given in and signed the new Geneva Convention, the United States would be producing such robots already.
We're a God-fearing country, Mr. Bergen, and only he may create life.
Mr. President, this isn't life. Convincing as it may be, it's still a robot. We call them hollow children.
Fire his eyes red, though.
If it's indistinguishable from humans, where does the machine end and life begin?
Well, this is philosophical bullshit. There are only two things that matter now. Number one, if you did not make this thing, then who did? And number two, why did it come after you?
What do we know about this hollow child?
It was granted a green card 30 years ago under the name Dominic Barry.
30 years? Jesus H. Christ!
If not for yesterday's events, we may never have found out it existed. We're now certain there are more living among us in America.
Well, now that's insane.
Not really, General.
Now just what in the hell do you think you're doing?
You see, it would appear that hollow children actually believe they're human.
Well, this is bullshit. I'm no goddamn...
Mr. President, I can think of only one man with the knowledge and resources to build this robot.
Dr. Yoji Amada. Recognized genius in the field of AI and founder of Amada, Japan's largest robotics corporation.
You don't sound too sure.
So this photograph is 40 years old. Amada hasn't been seen in public since.
That's crazy. He'd be 80 years old by now.
The Amada Corporation is in league with Japan's new order.
I read about them. Isolationists. Self-sufficiency, that's right?
Yes, sir. They wield a lot of influence over the Ministry of Homeland Affairs.
And you really think they're behind this infiltration?
Besides myself, Amada is the only man I know who's capable of this.
All right. Get me the IRTA in Geneva.
Woo! There's our way out, man.
Yeah.
What a plan, huh? Right?
Right.
The
this part of your big plan too?
Not precisely, I guess.
Whoa. What the hell is that?
Base to Beetle 2. We've reestablished the comm. Do you
Why? Read? Oh, shit.
Loud and clear, Major, but make it fast!
We have detected multiple rapid and intense heat signatures near the seawall. Looks like a large-scale battle.
And?
Well, radio chatter indicates that the Ministry is trying to flush out the resistance.
That's all fascinating, Major, but we got a situation over here. Go! Go!
Point is, stay in the seawall for a while. Right now, outside the wall, it's crawling with security.
Thanks for nothing, Major! So much for our covert op! Take them out!
Okay. Oh, yeah.
Whoa! Talk about a close one! Dan, watch out for those pegs!
F for duck. That sounds suspiciously like something
Whoa!
Else.
Ooh. I'm probably gonna die! I ever tell you I hate thrill rides?
Okay, we're getting hurt here. I doubt it.
This is the last time I listen to HQ! Isn't this over yet? Today just sucks! Whoa! Too fast, man! Shit! Looks like we plowed through it! Whoa! That don't look good. Jump for it!
That has got to hurt.
Hey, are you alright?
Huh?
Anything broken?
Are these two lovers or something?
Just my piece. Let's keep moving.
So, as it turns out, these guys actually do have like 3 health cuts in each. So, yeah. No wonder they weren't responding.
Yo, Dan, hide! So this is the resistance HQ was talking
about. I see.
Dan, of all the shit to stumble into!
Tell me about it. I see. Why are those guys shooting at us?
Man, this ain't fair. We ain't part of no resistance.
Oh, well, maybe they're flushing out illegal aliens, too.
Oh, we can, like, shift from cover to cover that way. That's interesting. That's interesting. We got a nice little headshot there.
Reloading!
I can't see half the enemies. Not clearly, anyway. Alright, moving up. Wait, I see like a new gun there.
Whoa, where did that come from?
So I'm gonna switch the pistol out for it. Nope, can't do that. Really can't do that. I'm here to try this shotgun out, so I think I'm just gonna stick to like the shotgun for now, for the time being. Although I'm not certain whether when I'm ever going to get the chance to test it out, but yeah. I think I'm gonna stick to it. Whoa, get out of my line of sight. You're being a health hazard to not only yourself, but also to me.
Base to Beetle 3, do you read?
You're kinda busy here, Major.
Sit rep.
Oh, never better. Where the hell is our rendezvous point?
Just keep going in that direction. You're almost
not
there.
What I wanted to do, but alright.
Check it out. Enemy transport.
Enemy transport.
They just keep coming and coming.
Ooh, this
assholes could have been bringing 6 packs.
The shotgun is not bad. Not half bad. I mean, it does have like a huge spread, but holy shit, look at that. That's not a bad gun. Not a bad gun at all. Holy shit. Let's go ahead and toss a like a frag there. Yeah, but this.
You see that?
This piece is not ideal for a shotgun, so might as well just go ahead and stick to our guns here.
Damn,
Man, leave some for the rest of us, huh? We got the bonus situation to think about.
All right.
Hey, don't mean I want to do all the work.
This gun probably makes the most sense for now, because I mean, I do want to switch over the shot, like switch out from the shotgun. What is this? Bulletproof skin burn for Dan only. Okay, that's interesting. I quickly want to run back and like get the other assault rifle, because I feel like that gun might just be better for this situation that we're in right now. I just hope we can go all the way back there without the game punishing us for it. This one? Right. Let us go and switch this out. And so which way? Yeah, that way. I got turned around. These are both ARs actually, but yeah, I'm hoping that one is slightly better than the other. ARs feel far more impactful, but at the same time, they just shoot all over the place.
Better watch out for an enemy ambush. Sniper, take cover! Look, a sniper rifle. Use it. Return fire.
Oh, I was actually hoping for something like that. But where's the sniper? I can hardly see it. Oh, it's a burst rifle? Never mind. Oh, I see. Holy shit. Yeah, I totally should be a little patient. Bo, can you like get out of the way, please? Thank you. All right. Let's take the sniper rifle over there and try and hit that guy. Wherever he is. Ah, he can't see me from this point. That's interesting. I was hoping that he would be able to. Looks like the guy tried shooting me, but sort of failed. I see you. Interesting.
I'll act as a decoy while you take those snipers.
There are
out.
More?
Take out those snipers. My life's in your hands, brother.
Where are they?
Here goes nothing.
Question is, where the fuck are these snipers?
Sniper at 9 o'clock.
I don't see any sniper. Over here? Oh, okay. That's too bad. This is like a weapon sway. I like this gun sways a bit.
Sniper at 3 o'clock.
Alright. Gotcha, fam. The gun sways a little. And those guys actually scream. Been dying. That's really interesting. I see another. That guy's like pretty prominent, to be honest. Stop swaying, come on. I can see some enemies popping out from over there. Let's just go ahead and toss that there. I don't know if it got anybody or not, but I think for these ranges I might as well just rely on the sniper instead. These guys... Oh, there's shotgun. Like, there's shotgun troopers. I see, that's interesting. Wait, there's a vending machine right here. Let me just go ahead and... Wait, I can't take cover back there? Are you kidding me? Those things are dead. Why can't I... Yeah, I seemingly can't take cover right there. So I guess the sidearm can't be swapped out because it's like your backup weapon for when you've got like when you want infinite ammo. I guess everybody said so. Let us go ahead and access the shop then. And yeah, let's see. Shopping. Light machine gun. Now I don't exactly want to replace the sniper. And I feel like we already have light machine gunner in the squad. I'll go ahead and buy some sniper ammo for myself. We have enough of this already. Let us go ahead and upgrade the guns instead. I mean, we could upgrade the rate of fire. And perhaps a bit of this as well. the number of rounds that are maxing outputs. Now then. Finally, it goes up to 2000, but I guess I should have made the purchases in the last terminal itself. Would have been a little better, I feel like, because the prices were better there. It was like just 1000 credits each. Alright. What do we want here? Let's give him some range and accuracy. I feel like that might be more important to Bo and his gun, because his gun shoots all over the place. Okay, we lost again. I see the enemy. Enemy spotted.
Man, they just don't give up.
Apparently not. What can you do about it, huh? Bo, you are in the way. Get out before you get hurt. Are the enemies dead? Excuse me there. Any enemies inside? None that I can see. Is that under the sales terminal over there?
Let's finish this.
I mean, with that few enemies, we can probably ask Bo to actually like charge the area. But I don't see any reason why we should not be sticking together, to be honest. Look at these guys, they're like fighting for us now. That's amazing. Yeah, I guess that's the end of the combat, because none of these guys are
Let's mow them down.
Shooting at us anymore. So, I suppose that's good. There's another like terminal right here. I guess that guy finally died. Let's go next to this terminal, see what if it has anything new for us. This is like a handgun, like a new handgun for us. However, it has low ammo capacity and high recoil. Kiss grenade. Okay. Sticky kiss grenade, which attaches to any surface dealing with high explosive damage. When purchased, it will replace any other explosives currently equipped. What about this? This might just replace a handgun entirely, actually. Who knows? Assault rifle ammo, I don't really think we need it. Shotgun ammo. Yeah, I'll switch over to like something better later. Don't really need it right now. Okay, heavy gunner 2. Let's go ahead and get that. And power boost 1. Alright. EMP grenade. Explodes a set time after being thrown, triggering an electromagnetic pulse that disables small to medium-sized robotic enemies. I feel like this actually makes more sense. But the problem is we can only afford one of this. Oh well, we were running out of grenades anyway. Did we get... Oh wait, we never purchased the other handgun, did we?
Yo, rendezvous point ain't far now. Finally get to meet our new British friend. Philip said the guy's ex-MI6. A real agent, not some pencil pusher. So watch your back, alright? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Multinational unit sounds all fine and dandy, but everyone's got their own agenda.
Exactly.
And that includes us. You and me, brother. We trust each other and nobody else. It is what it is.
Well, yes.
Whoa, listen to me. We getting old, brother. Stop me if I'm boring you.
Not precisely. God damn. Why would you say... How is that a response?
For pardon fucking me. Sorry to spoil your day. Alright. Enough chatter.
I didn't think about what I was replying with. But I'm eager to try out this. Oh, a shield for a sidearm. That's interesting. But before that, I would like to go ahead and... Yeah. Essentially, equip Big Boo with some of the other skills that we just got for him. Including this one. Health, Giga Strength 2. Beast health by 15. Let us go ahead and replace Giga Strength 1. Wish these could work in tandem. It actually can work in tandem. This is like defense plus 10. And what is this? It's like health plus 15. This is like health plus 10. I guess we'll have to make do with this for the time being. Power boost. Alright, let's switch over to Dan. Let's see if we have anything for him. Shot protection 1, bulletproof skin 1. I feel like we already have the better variants here. That improves base health. Health 10, reload speed, defense 10. Yeah, we've got the better ones already. Alright, yeah, defense plus 10, and that's precisely what this does, but with just one orb instead of two. So I guess we'll stick to this instead. Alright, let us go ahead and blast these doors open, I suppose. Or not. Or not. That's, I guess that's my bad. Yeah. Oh, I was thinking, since when did that gun get that?
Another greeting party. So let's say
that
good.
Oh, I see. You know what? Let me go take some cover instead and use this grenade right here. Okay, I wish it would have gotten tossed a little further, but oh well, it is what it is. Let us go ahead and holy shit, talk about aim punch. Alright, we need to use this better. Totally miss with that. Probably because I'm getting a lot of aim punch there. What do you mean, shock troopers?
Whoa, where did that come from? Hit me in your heels, man. Don't back down.
Okay, we need to be careful here because we're totally getting shredded right now. And
Fire!
Yeah, we can't shoot through those shields there. Let's get rid of their legs instead. Or maybe... yeah, that also works. Shooting them in the legs, I mean. Excuse me? Alright, anything... yeah, just one last here. I'm guessing that his buddy sort of shot him there. Unless it was Bo. Who knows? Huh, that was a difficult battle. The first time I've had to use like a revive kit. This thing isn't really all that good because, well, the pistol, it's a...
over here!
It's an okay weapon at most.
No, they're human!
Children, actually.
And how in the hell can you tell that?
How in the hell can't you? Look at them. They're just kids.
Huh. Weapon scavengers. Never seen them start this young.
War strange, isn't it?
Nice guns. I could get a lot of money for those. Why don't you hand them over?
Kid, it's 2-on-1, and these guns are way bigger than yours.
Huh? Should have taken those kids out, huh?
So much for 2-on-1.
Yeah. You know, killing kids isn't my idea of fun.
Drop them. Now.
They ain't green. Reckon they want to light us up.
I wonder what their parents would be thinking of them now.
Hey, I said drop your weapons. Are you deaf?
Looks like the robot story.
I guess it wasn't quite finished. Happens sometimes with scrap heads. Seen a lot of good soldiers taken out like that. Now, you were saying about our guns?
Nah, I figure we owe you one now. So I've changed my mind.
Well, how about that?
Pretty dangerous work for kids.
We do what we have to. Resisting pays good money for these scraphead weapons. Food on the table, you know?
You should find a new line of work for these kids. Seems like most of them have forgotten how to smile.
Pretty sure they would have smiled very, very wide if they had a chance to shoot these guys.
Like any of us has a choice. Look around you, Yankee man. No future!
Come on, Dan. Ain't nothing we could do.
Japanese games tend to get philosophically heavy like that.
Damn, look at this place. Anyone attacks now, we're gonna look like burger patties. All part of the thrill, right, brother? Telling you, man, live around here long enough and we'd all wind up looking like them kids back there.
That's certain.
No hope, no future.
Never.
How'd it all end up this way, man?
At this point, I wish I had the shotgun with me.
Base? Where's that Rondi?
Should be at your 2 o'clock.
I see it.
Flashlight.
Over there!
That's more like one.
Man needs new batteries.
It's Morse code. I ain't seen that in years.
What's next? Smoke signals?
He's stuck there.
Whoa! We got company!
Let's give him a warm welcome.
Indeed.
They're in the air too! This is bullshit!
I'm not just aiming for that big guy right there.
I got the aerial units! Gonna blast them out of the sky!
Don't know whether I'm hitting the correct part or not. Yep.
Didn't sign up for this shit.
So you say. So you say. Now while they're fighting amongst each other, I'll just go ahead and take these guys out. Actually, I would prefer getting them in the head instead. But looks like these guys are a little too mobile for me. Can I move there? Thank you. Sticking around the mouth of this thing here. I mean, I see some health kits right here. Are you done?
Brother, but quit hogging all the glory.
Really? I mean, you need to get better, son. Where did the minigun go? That's unreasonable. Like, seriously. Why not just leave the minigun behind while you go, you know? That's it. Short section there. Oh no.
Don't this boy ever get tired?
It's like he's cheesing them. He's got a personal vendetta against them. That's a lot of firepower for two soldiers.
That scrap head is really starting to bug me.
Fire in the hole!
Shit!
Impressive. That's when you take it out. I was hoping they would make it stronger though. What's the point of a...
Hombucho, Roppongi demo red alert desu. Keibi koudou chuu no Grand Lancer kara ki no teishi shingo.
Teibou ni shinryu shita renchuu da na?
Eh, sono yo desu.
Grand Lancer wo taoshita no ka? Eraku juu soubi de kita mon da.
本部長、お台場での画像です。
ただの密入国じゃないな、こいつは。内務大臣につなげ。
Everybody alive? Holler if you're dead.
You know, it's funny, but my briefing said this was to be a covert operation. Come on.
What can I say? I like to make an entrance. So, you must be Charlie.
It's Commander Charles Gregory to you, thanks. British Division.
Yeah, XMI6, right? I kinda guessed that.
Is it supposed to be me? Yeah. We all are. This is Lieutenant Rachel Townsend.
Sergeant Dan Marshall, ex-Special Forces.
Sergeant Roy Botang. Ditto.
So, I'm to babysit you two then, yeah? Think you can stay out of trouble in future?
What can I say? They started it.
Ace to beat a one.
Loud and clear, Ace.
Sorry to burden you with my clowns.
No disrespect intended, sir, but you Yanks do tend to make a lot of noise. Know what I mean?
Not all of us, Gregory. Just those two.
So, where's everybody else?
Well, the French are already inside the city.
They said there'd be a Chinese squad, too.
File photo doesn't do her justice.
She looks familiar. Reminds me of an actress or someone.
Come on, Bo, you know the only movies you watch are porn. Oh, yeah, right, with the... Hey, watch this. Excuse me. Hi, I'm Dan, and that is my partner, Bo.
Ni hao.
Ah, the strong and silent type, huh? I like that in a woman.
Maybe if you pair learnt some manners, she might not be so silent.
Yeah, rough with the smooth, man. So, this is all China sent, huh? Just one woman?
I am First Lieutenant Fei Li of the People's Liberation Army. My two subordinates were killed by security robots on the way here.
Aw, shit, listen. We didn't mean no disrespect.
Hard to believe you're the one they called a survivor.
Well, appearances can be deceiving.
Ain't that special. Just real lucky.
No luck? Well, that's good. Because we could all do with a bit of luck. Because the Japs consider anyone without official ID as an invading hostile. So, we're all in the crosshairs.
Speaking of, sir, we'd better get moving.
Right, Beta 1 to base. Now moving to first contact rendezvous.
Roger that. Base out.
Got some local help in the Shibuya flood zone. It's this way.
The 21st century started off pretty bad, and only got worse. Sea levels rose. Climate went to hell. Three quarters of the major cities around the world were flooded, ruined, and uninhabitable. Local and national authorities rebuilt upward, above the waterline. Whole new cities, using the old as foundations, and leaving the lower layers, the flood layers, to rot and decay. But a lot of people had already died as the world collapsed. Who was going to build these incredible new structures? Robots. I call them scrapheads. But then, I've never been a fan. Not that anyone cares what I think. Fact is, we needed robot labor like never before. One company rose to dominate the market. Bergen Advanced Robotics Technology from the USA. Bergen has a 95% share of the global robotics industry. Of course, they didn't get there without ruffling a few feathers. Most famously, the Amada Corporation in Japan sued Bergen for stealing its technology. But by then, Bergen was already huge, and Amada lost its case. That was the last obstacle between Bergen and world domination. Thanks to them, the USA is now the global superpower. In 2040 AD, the world's remaining economic concerns ratified the new Geneva Convention. One of the most controversial parts of it was Clause 21, which banned research into robots that could pass for human, or hollow children, as the media called them. 40 years later, a hollow child attacked Bergen's headquarters in the USA. He didn't just fool the humans. He seemed to have no idea he was a robot himself. I'm Sergeant Dan Marshall. I work for the IRTA, the International Robotics Technology Association out of Geneva. The IRTA set up a global task force called Rust Crews to deal with breaches of the convention, especially Clause 21. We've got full support from the US military, which is where I used to work anyway. Some things never change. And that's how me and my partner Bo ended up in Japan, because the US suspects the hollow child who turned up in America was made by Yoji Amada, legendary robotics genius and the founder of Amada Corporation. We're here to arrest Amada and take him to Geneva at any cost. That means we get to knock out any scrappers that try to stop us along the way. I sure hope they try.